So don't forget, you teach them, so I'm not going to cue everything. On your back. So bring yourself neutral pelvis, bring your legs into tabletop. Bring yourself into curler. Heels together, toes apart. Lengthen your legs away, squeeze your inner thighs together, off we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 2, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 3, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 4, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 5, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 6, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 7, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, hold, legs down, hands go over your head, to the floor, and big stretch, breathe in, and roll up, into spine stretch, come into a spine good, roll up, and then have a nice stretch forward, belly in, reach, 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 sit up nice and tall, point. Tuck the tailbone under, exhale, roll back. Hands above the head, have a big stretch. Flex the feet. Breathe in, hands to ceiling, exhale. Spine stretch forward. Roll back, stay there, hands down next to you. Bend your feet into semi-supine. Double knee fold, straighten your legs up towards the ceiling. And lower the legs ever so slightly and then into rollover. Hold it there, straighten those knees, send your hands towards me. Flex, open your knees hip width, closer back in. And then roll down, keeping them flexed, straight, 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 straight knees. When you get there, hold. Point, feet together. Drop slightly, inhale, exhale, roll over. Straight knees, 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 knees. Flex, open, roll down. Now hold it when you get to the bottom. Keep them flexed, roll over. Bring them together. Point, roll down. So one more. Open, flex, roll over. Bring them together. Point, roll down. Keep the legs there. Take the hands up towards the ceiling. Right leg down to the floor. Take it to the corner of the mat. Flex, push the heel in the ground. Six circles one way, six circles the other way. Finish keeping the leg up to the top. Then, as you bring your leg down, you're going to bring the other one up. Six circles one way, take that leg out to the corner. Six circles one way, six circles the other. And then both legs flat on the floor. Straight on the floor, should I say. Who's your arms hanging back in?
No.
Ceiling. Yeah, send your hands above your head, roll up. Shimmy yourself to the front of the mat, riding like a ball. Keep rolling like balls. Off you go.
Three.
Three. A big nice. Finish in your starting position. Okay. Left, so you're going to have your right hand on left knee, left hand on your left ankle. And you're going to roll back very slowly as you straighten your right leg. Good. Three single leg switches. One. Two. Again. Three. Bring both legs in. Hands next to your knees. Double leg stretch. Take a breath in. Exhale. Legs go out. Arms towards the ceiling. Circle around. Bring it in. One more. Exhale out. Circle it around. Bring it in. Straighten your arms towards the floor, straighten your legs. down to the floor and roll up. So you can do this all up the mat. Spine stretch. So feet hip width or a little bit wider. Arms up in front. Deep breath. Exhale, chest to chest, belly button. And roll yourself forward. Keeping the arms high. When you can't go anymore, reach forward. Flex those heels, send those heels towards me. Belly button to the wall behind you. Grow nice and tall. One more. Relax your shoulders. Inhale, chin tuck. Reach forward, belly button. Good. And then grow nice and tall. Bring yourself back to the front of the mat, rolling up in ball position. This time, instead of holding your ankles like that, you're going to hold your ankles like that. Straighten your left leg. Bring it back down. Straighten your right leg. Bring it back down. Straighten both. If you need to, hold behind the thighs. Bring your legs closer back in. Straighten the back. And open leg rock. Or if you go three rocks. When you get to the top, make sure you have a nice long spine. Hold your open leg rocker there. Bring your legs together. Let go of your legs and roll down onto your back. Keep your legs up. Yeah, hands next to you. Good. Hands on the floor. Hip roll to the left. Roll over to your left shoulder. Where are you going?
That's the one, sorry.
Over to your right shoulder.
Do you come down? And then, yeah, you do.
And then center. Over to your right hip roll. Right shoulder. Left shoulder. Roll down on your hip roll. Finish center. Legs down to the floor. Roll yourself up into seated. So take a deep breath in, exhale, big stretch, inhale up, rotate to the right, exhale, inhale up, rotate, exhale. So each time you breathe out, go deeper, gongs are heavy. When you finish on your right part side, make that your last one. I'm actually being nice, but not getting you to do minutes, so it might be an hour. Lie onto your front for swan dive. So hands on the floor, elbows down, 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 down. Legs wide, toes turn out. Good. So draw your belly button in. Put your shoulder blades together, sliding down to your back pocket. Squeeze your bum, start to lengthen yourself up. So when you come up, you can stay at this level if you want to. If you want to go into a swan dive prep, you can just take your hands away, keep looking up at me, keep your bum solid, your legs solid, and then can you put your hands back there. So let gravity pull you. Good. If you want to continue that, you're just going to take your arms to the sides. Remember, this is all glute, 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 glute. But keep looking up. Good, nice. Good. And then hands back there. I'll be nice, just take a moment, see if you want to do a child. So single leg kick, your choice whether you want to be lying on your hands, whether you want to be up there, or whether you want to be up tall. Whichever version, if you're on your knuckles or tall, make sure you are not sinking in your shoulders. Lengthen your legs away, legs together. So, because it's you two, you're going to go a little bit harder than beginner's level. So squeeze your bum, lengthen your legs away, knees off the floor. Left heel to bum. And then as you lengthen your leg away, you're going to lift that knee a little bit higher. And then other leg. So see how slow you can bring your heel to your bum. While you are squeezing as hard as you can. So technically, you shouldn't get the heel to the arms. Feeling it? Each time you bring that leg down, lift that knee. Good. And your right leg relax. lie down onto your forehead, hands can either be there or there. Legs are together. Unless you tighten the hips, you can have your legs wide as well. So belly button, squeeze your legs, your thighs, your bums lengthen away. Front of the body stays down, legs go up. Now kick to your bum twice, one, two. Then as you send your legs down, you're going to lift up through the top half of the body and reach those hands down. Alternatively, you can be in a dart. And then bring your head back down, hands back up, two kicks. One, two, lengthen down. Good.
Is head up or down?
Ideally up. And relax, child pose. And then coming to seated on your mat, legs straight out in front, hands crossed behind the top. Back in abdominal, good in that core. So first of all, starting nice and tall, flex the heels, reach up on the heels. So we're going to hinge. Take a deep breath in as you exhale, a little bit of a hinge. Tuck the tailbone under into roll back. One vertebra at a time as you go. At the bottom, breathe in. Exhale, keep your hands there, roll up. Bring the head to the knees. Good, head to knees. Now lift your elbows up towards the ceiling and now push your head up into your hands. Good. Sit up nice and tall, elbows in your peripheral vision. One more. Hinge. Tuck the tailbone under. Roll back. Breathe in, roll up, head to knee. Elbows wide, head into hands, and relax. Good. So roll yourself back, and you're going to bring yourself up into bridge, shoulder bridge. So knee fold first, and then pop your hands under your bum. So remember, we want to try and be nice and high. That's going to come from the bums. And when you scissor, your focus is this bottom leg. How low can you take this bottom leg without falling? This is hip flexor stretching. And then we're going to take that into bicycles. So your bottom leg, when you take it as far as you can, bend and then pull it through, change. Bend, pull it through. So when you do your bicycle, can you feel, once you bend that leg, can you feel that stretch in the front of the hip? So take that as low, low, low as you can. Oh, your arms are on it. Yeah. And then straighten your legs up towards the ceiling. So this is your choice now. If you want to do the other one, you're going to turn your hands, your butt, any leg is going to start to come down. Make a little bit of a back bend when you do that to touch the floor. Otherwise, you can just do a... Oh, well done! Good job! Heels down. And then right leg. Straighten. Yeah, flex. Drive it down. Three kicks up and down. Switch legs. Good. Well done, Becky. And... Oh. And then once you've done those, take your hands away and roll down. And I'll be nice, give yourself a meal. Sometimes we're actually quite far through it.
You're going to add in. Do two rounds.
It's a bit forward and back. I guess we do that. So, spine twist. So come into seated, roll yourself up. Your choice, you can do that one. Or that one. So taking a deep breath into the left, go around, run, 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 as much as you can. Remember your neck, make sure your hips are not moving.
Oh, shoot.
So hold it at the side, so goes the left. Hold. Take a deep breath in, lengthen. Exhale, can you go further? Good. Inhale, center. Relax. Inhale to the right. Go, 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 go. Inhale, lengthen. Can you go deeper? Breathe out deeper, 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 deeper. Inhale, lengthen, center. One more each side. Shoulders. our main time movement. Roll yourself down. Can you?
Yeah.
I was just gonna say, can you feel how this is an all body workout?
Yeah.
It's just everything's on fire.
Yeah.
And I was gonna say, can you feel the heat?
Yeah.
So jackknife. Hands down next to you. Knee fold into legs straight up towards the ceiling. So use your hands if you need to with this. Get your hands under your bum, and you want. Ideally, you don't want to use your hands, but to help you, you want your feet there. So the more you squeeze, good. Now, you want to keep that space as you come down. You want to keep your legs from dropping over your head as you peel yourself down. So use your arms. Yeah.
It's actually giving me a bit of a headache because you're.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's keeping it all back there.
Yeah. So push it to your arms. Push.
Yeah. So when you do Torquay, is it meant to be like really like you're flat?
Yeah, you've got to stay. You've got to keep that space open the whole time as you come down.
That's really army, isn't it?
Yeah. And again, you get to a point where you can't squeeze the bum.
Yeah.
Because you get to a point where you need to start
to let it go to come down. Yeah. Oh, Jesus.
So that was jackknife. Side kick. So onto your knees, face the front here. That leg is out. I've done the wrong one. Lie on your side, apologies. And so lie on your side. Again, I'll leave that choice. You can either be right up, you can be there, or you can be flat. Bottom leg, front corner. Engage the muscles, push it into the floor. Three kicks forward and back, I'll be nice. Without movement. Forward. When you get there, little secret, the more you squeeze, the more you'll lock. And then go to the other side. Three kicks on that side. And go back in.
Yeah, it swings up, doesn't it?
Yeah. For most people it will, that's what you're going to watch. So three kicks one side, three kicks roll over to the other side. Okay, noticing which side is easier, which side is harder.
Still swings forward. I'm trying.
So don't forget, pause is a very...
But
if you focus more on what you're actually doing rather than trying to kick it back,
and extending out,
flow more.
As well.
So think of reaching out through the front, squeeze in the back rather than having that.
Yeah, I find it more easy
controlled
when you do it slower.
When you have more thought. Yeah. So to say it's wrong, it's different. This is what I like to teach slower.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, I actually need to think about what I'm doing.
Yeah, but then I know that I'm feeling it. You need to know you can do it to then do it quicker.
So lie on your backs, arms above your head, and allow the legs lock. So deep breath in. As you peel up, head and feet are going to come off the floor at the same time into teaser.
As you breathe in.
You have a play with your breath and see what happens. Good. Now, keep your body in exactly the same place. You're going to lower your legs halfway down. Good. Pull them up. Now, keep your legs in the same place. Lower your body halfway down. Roll up. Now, both halfway down. And up. And now, both all the way down, head, feet down at the same time. Roll up into seated. Pop your hands behind you, lengthen your legs out in front of you, hip twists. You can do this bent legs or straight legs. So bring your legs up into whatever position you want. Hip roll to the left. Little half, not so much banking. Half circle round so that you're in a hip roll to the right. Come back to center.
Are we going at the top or
no?
No, down option.
Yeah, so you go side, down, center. Cross, side, down.
Sweating.
So with your hip twists, if you think of, you know when you do it on the floor, the toes don't separate, there's no separation of the knees, whether you do it in that position. And it's coming from lumbar parts of the spine, not thoracic, so it's in your, always think where the belly button is, in that area of the spine.
I just can't get the range of movement, it's usually smaller than.
Who said it's going to be big? Providing you are doing a little hip roll, you can make them. But you've got to be able to control.
Yeah, that's the thing. I could use my. And then it's not in my shoulder. Yeah, it's not high. Right, okay.
You've got to be able to. It's again, contrology. If you're doing a really big move and you're losing control, you're not controlling it, so making them smaller. Better to do a really small one with complete control than go. Okay, hip twist. Come to front line for swimming. You're going to do swimming for a count of 10 and then take yourself into a child's pose after that.
Could
it
be
right
again?
So reaching away, reach the arms, the legs, squeeze the bum, tummy in, lengthen the back up, lengthen the legs up, opposite arm, opposite leg. And your aim is to go as fast as you can without rocking and without bending your legs. If you're rocking, squeeze your body harder. Count to 10 and then child pose. There's something in you that you lose as you, you start off and then there's a little
and then something,
concentration or something. Or fatigue. Good. But you see how tired you are. Yes, we have done a load of classicals.
So
bring yourself into plank on your hands. So maintaining your plank, you're going to rock forward, bringing your shoulders in front of your wrists. Going back up through the, hold it there. Push up through there, there. And then push down through the back of your heels. So you can keep it there if you want to make it harder. You can bring one leg in as you go forward and then push it back as you go. And then change legs. And then relax. Onto your bums. Bring any back. You've done that in one. Not even. Easy when you're teaching people you've just done it with. But the normal class will take about an hour. So, pointing or flexing, tuck the tailbone under and over. Traditionally, they took the head back. Your choice whether you want head back or head forward to your perineals. So lift that bum back in. And then you can add the leg kick. This is Tina's favorite move. So you point up, flex down, point up, flex down. And it's all in the bum.
Which is obviously.
That's what I said. Have a play with where you think the feet. I find it so much harder, apart from the ankle injury, it's so much harder with the feet pointed.
Yeah.
I feel I have a lot more control when I'm feeling flexed. Side note, side kick me in my face, that's why.
We get an angle.
Feet, so onto your knees, front of the mat. Front of the mat. Hand, front of the mat there. Toe, front of the mat there. So, back of the head. shoulder blades, bum, back ankle against the wall behind you. So remember, people have a tendency to want to look down. Send the head back. So you think, you can see your elbow at the corner of your hand, that needs to be up the whole time. So you can either sweep the floor, or if you want to work harder, engage and lift. Six kicks. You can add a little circling if you want to. So again, you can go point, flex, point, flex. We're going to have a break in a minute, Tina, then you can
make a noise.
You can make a noise.
Laugh first.
I wouldn't dream of
it. Switch sides. Six kicks.
Bash it a bit further.
You're just feeling it on the bottom leg. Six kicks. So again, dissociation of the hip. The whole thing is pulling in. Getting that thigh moving inside of the hip without the rest of you moving. We need to go, side bends. Side bends. Do one, take it into a thread, open it up, come down, and then do the other side.
So, yeah, that's how it goes.
Yeah?
Is it?
Top knee is facing, yeah? Make sure you're looking at the platform and make sure that hand's quite far. There we go. So remember, you're pushing up first and then out. Good. So that your shoulders are above your wrist. There we go, hand up. Thread the needle. Think of the downward dog thing. And then I just worry about your shoulder. And then take it back up. And come down. Over to the other side. Just face that wrist. Push up and shoulder over the wrist. Thread, so keep threading back, more, push into that, good, and now bring it back out, yeah, and if you want to, it's a little bit of an arm open extension, good, and then bring it back down. Boomerang, so make sure you're not too far, the back of your mat is better to be a little bit closer, have your left crossed over right. Hands resting on the floor. If you need to, you can give yourself a little bit of a cushion with the hands, but try and use the core that you are when you're very tired. So, breath in as you exhale, lift the legs into teaser position. Tuck the tailbone under, roll over. Use your hands to help push you into the rollover. Hold the rollover. Switch your legs round. So, hold this position, please. I want you to think of this length coming out. So, pull. And now, roll down, keep your chin tucked in, allowing momentum to help you into teaser. Hold your teaser, you need to bend your legs to make it a bit more easier. Now, take your hands around the back, stretch that chest open, legs down, head to knee. Bring the hands round, butterfly. And then hold onto your feet and have a little bit of a stretch. So one more, sitting nice and tall. So your legs are now switched, ready for another one. So ready? Lengthen the legs up, tummy in, tailbone under, rollover. Hold your rollover. Send your heels to the front window. Switch your legs. Now as you come down, keep your chin tucked in, roll up into teaser. Go. There. Good. Arms around the back. Stretch that chest. Lovely. Feet down. Head to knees. Good. Well done. Hands around the feet.
Oh,
and relax.
Did it.
Very nice. Very good. Yes, very good.
My arm's like,
oh. You're going to get people that can't reach.
Yeah, that's true.
So, front to the front, rolling like a ball position, ready for steel. So, we're going to be holding the inside of the feet. Yeah? You're going to clap the soles together three times. One, two, three. Roll back like a ball. Clap. Up and down. Yeah. And then roll up. So, two more. So, another knot on the neck. It's going to be on that part over there. And then into
chest control.
That's a real control. Yeah. So, I'm not doing clap. Rocking, so line your front.
Stick to this now. Oh, really? It is weird.
Yeah. So take hold of your feet. So depending on the level you want to work at, this might be enough, but squeeze your hips down and then start to send your heels away from your bum. Engage those muscles around the shoulder blades as you push your heels away from the bum, let the top half of the body come up. So just hang on to your feet. Allow the knees to come off the floor. If you want to start rocking, you're going to draw those feet in, push them away. You can also just have your hands resting next to your legs so that you come into a little bit of dark rock. And relax.
Oh, look at that. Okay.
Child pose. Child pose.
You see the more extension on
So come into onto your back. So this is fine.
In your knees and your knees. In the old days, you just used to be slim,
fit. Legs, double knee fold, straighten your legs up to the ceiling. So, into roll over. And now, you want to take your toes as close to the floor as you can. Balance, swing your arms around and grab hold of one foot. So the other foot, you're going to straighten as much as you can up towards the ceiling, really engaging in the glutes while not trying to fall over. Bring that leg down, switch legs. And again, reach up and up and up and up and up with a straight leg. Bring the leg down. Bring your arms back down to the side. And roll down. And then we are going to come into standing at the end of your mat.
I'm definitely feeling slight difference with my hamstrings.
They are. Tina's been doing that. When I first started Pilates, Tina was like, that wasn't mine. Yeah. My hamstrings. I couldn't do rocking or any of the things.
I feel I should be doing it.
Yes, you should. I can only do my mat. Yeah, because it hurt me.
So, ready? Chin to chest, keep the arms next to the ears, roll down. If you need to bend your legs, bend your legs. Complete stability in the pelvis. This comes from your arms. So come up with it in your bum. Knees down. So beautiful. Focus on your shoulder, scapular stability. Elbows in. Even if you just do half. Push up. Come into down dog. You're going to do both legs, and then as you walk back, hips stable, 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 stable. From there, keep your arms next to your head. Take a breath in as you roll up, keeping those arms next to your head. All the way to standing. Bring your hands down. Yay! Good job! That was it.
Tell the camera, how are you feeling after classical?
Shattered.
Hot.